Goldenhar syndrome was first described by Maurice Goldenhar in 1952. So this is a syndrome derived from aberrations in the development of first and second branchial arches, similar to Treacher-Collins syndrome. Commonly autosomal dominant inheritance, but autosomal recessive and multifactorial inheritance pattern have been reported. Goldenhar syndrome, otherwise called oculo-auriculo-vertebral dysplasia. The name itself points to the abnormalities. Ocular, that is in the eye, epibulbar dermoid tumors and eyelid colobomas. Auricular, that is in the ear, preauricular tag, anosia, microtia and hearing loss. Hearing loss is usually conductive as in Treacher-Collins syndrome, but sensorineural hearing loss can also happen. Abnormalities of stria vascularis and semicircular canals are also noted. Ear abnormalities ranging from anosia to preauricular tag, they are considered the most common malformation in Goldenhar syndrome. There is also vertebral abnormality noted. They are the scoliosis, hemivertebra and cervical fusion. There is also presence of problems with the dentition, cleft lip, palate, renal abnormalities, congenital heart disease, etc. And the classical triad is mandibular hypoplasia, ocular and auricular malformations and vertebral abnormalities. There are some differences between this Goldenhar and Treacher-Collins syndrome. Mainly one is in the inheritance, that is one is autosomal. Treacher-Collins is basically purely autosomal dominant, but as I told, Goldenhar, that it can be autosomal recessive also. And the hearing loss is always conductive in Treacher-Collins, but it can be conductive and also sensorineural or mixed pattern is also seen in a Goldenhar syndrome. And the treatment is usually symptomatic and include a combination of supportive, medical and surgical modes of therapy. Feeding assistance, hearing aid and spectacles are commonly used.